One politician who knows a thing or two about building a cabinet is Canada's 20th Prime Minister, the Right Honourable Jean Chrétien. He served in the cabinets of Lester B. Pearson and Pierre Trudeau, holding key portfolios like finance and justice, and of course, went on to build his own cabinets after winning three consecutive majority governments. Now, Chrétien is reflecting on his time in power with a second volume of his biography, My Stories, My Time. Jean Chrétien gave his thoughts on key issues facing the government and the country earlier this week in an interview with Rosemary Barton.
Mr. Chrétien, nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Appreciate you being here. I want to start with my condolences about your wife, Eline, who you dedicate the book to. You call her your Rock of Gibraltar, which is what I know you called her throughout. I just wonder how you're doing.
Well, I'm doing all right. You know, there's nothing you can do. I miss her a lot. We were married 63 years, and we were boyfriend and girlfriend for five previous years. So 68 years that we talk every day. She was very useful to me. She was, you know, the Rock of Gibraltar. Well, she can talk to me and in a nice way and tell me the truth and tell me when to be serious and when to be different and so on, and helping me to make some very important decisions.
Yes.
And because she was a calm, quiet, but great observer, and she had been with me since the beginning. You know, she started to listen to me making speeches. She was she was 18, so it was part of her life too.
Yeah. Justin Trudeau's announcing his cabinet on Tuesday, as you know, and you write in this book about how difficult cabinet making was from time to time, particularly in 1993, when you had to somehow get your opponents, your leadership opponents, into cabinet, with Sheila Copps and Paul Martin, of course. How difficult is cabinet making from your perspective?
It's difficult because you have all sort of constraints. You have to have at least one representative from every province, and you have to problem of language, of religion, of sex, and so on. So you have to mix that up and try to have the best you can have. And it's very, very difficult. And you know that for one person who is pleased, there's 10 who are very unhappy. This is a very difficult task, and you're alone. That is very, the last minute you're alone. You have you have to decide. I remember making a cabinet shuffle on a table in a restaurant in Korea. You know, I still have the little, I did it on a piece of paper from the restaurant. I still have it.
Just know, the names that you were moving
around. The name
around.
And the possibility there and the possibility here and so on.
Wow.
You know, and it's what was going on in my mind.
Yeah. You also write about minority governments in your book, and you say that, you know, we've had lots of minority governments, but you say that it surprises you that we've never had a coalition. Why do you think that is? Why do you think we have not been so open to that?
I don't know. I think the people start with the presumption that a minority government will not last very long.
Yes.
Very few minority governments last more than 2 years, 2 years and a half. So we don't. I don't know. We could do that, but there is no appetite for it. But it is. I said to Justin after the second election, I said, in a way, you're lucky. I never had a minority government. For me, who love politics, I always thought it would be politics at its best.
Yes.
You know, you have to advance and back down and so on and make compromise and, as I said, walk on the paint when you corner yourself and so on. That type of thing is something, because I was involved in minority governments. I was a parliamentary secretary to Mike Pearson in 65, and after that with Mitchell Sharp, and you know, and the budget is key. So I was involved in the dealing, and we had one too under Mr. Trudeau when, you know, in 1972.
Yeah.
So, and I was in the opposition for the minority government of Joe Clark.
I'm glad you brought up that anecdote, because I was going to quote that exact quote to you from the book, because I found it kind of hard to believe. Most people would want a majority. You know, Mr. Trudeau, Jr.
I want a majority. Yeah. It's better to operate.
Yes.
But as a person who likes politics, the art of politics, for me, it's something that I didn't want to have, but I would have enjoyed having it in a way. Mm. I prefer to have a majority government. And the people of Canada wanted to give me a majority government. Yes. So what can I say?
Yes, indeed. You talk about Mitchell Sharp there, and you talk in the book about Mitchell Sharp and how important it is when you're governing to have experience around you. And Mitchell Sharp was who you turned to for a lot of advice. And you also say that the Trudeau team, the current team, talks sometimes about how they've sidelined the old guard. Do you think they have enough experience around them now? Do you, you obviously talk to them occasionally?
I don't want to pass judgment. You know, for me, it's not my role.
Yeah.
I did it differently.
Yes.
And I remember when I became prime minister, I discussed with Pierre Trudeau what will be our relation.
Yes.
And he said, don't feel obliged to call me. He said, you're very different than me. You will have a different government. But I'm very confident, he told me, you have the same values because we have shared them for 15 years in the cabinet and so on. And I, you know, they don't consult me. And, you know, not much. And that's fine for me. I'm not there. It's not my responsibility.
Yeah. But you do see value in having people, you yourself.
But I do that because I'm the product of that.
Yes.
You know, when Mr. Pearson, I was his parliamentary secretary, and he sent me with Mitchell Sharp. And he said, Jean, you're going there to learn, because, he thought that I had some. So he had a lot of experience, and he became my mentor. And I think I learned it's much better than to have a course from some teachers in some university.
I want to ask you about China, because it comes up twice in the book, particularly China and Meng Wanzhou. You clearly disagreed with the government's approach. You had your own ideas. Now that the two Michaels have returned home, do you think that it worked what they did, or you still
but
think...
But, you know, we lost 3 years. Yeah. That is a problem, and they stayed in jail 2 years. 3 years. So I thought that... at the beginning, that they should have moved earlier, and I told that, and I mentioned that publicly, and I wrote about it in the book.
Yes.
This is, because I had been called by Chinese people, because I always had good relations with China. One time, Zhu Rongji, the prime minister, had said in front of 5,000 people in the Great Hall in Beijing that Canada was the best friend of China. And but I was going there. I went there twice with Team Canada, 500 Canadians, and all the premiers and so on. Mm-hmm. So we had developed a good relation. And everybody says, I was very candid with them. In fact, I made a speech on human rights in Beijing in a university with the camera there, ours and theirs. I did the same thing in front of the national... annual meeting of the judges in Shanghai.
Yeah.
So, but at the same time, they don't always agree with you, and most of the time we have to say we agree to disagree.
Do you think that Canada needs to change its approach to China? We go back to the kind of Team Canada thing you write about?
But the different times today, I have to recognize. At that time, we had recognized China before... the United States and many others. And for me, my family was involved because Canada Business Council was founded by Paul Desmarais.
Mm-hmm.
And the first real after Trudeau had opened the gate. And, and so I had a special relationship with the Chinese, and I knew some of them, and I remained quite friendly with them. We had disagreement, but now they have become a power.
Yes.
And now they're playing as a power. I'm not surprised.
Yeah.
Everybody around the table thinks about his own interest first. So you have to start with that. Nobody, wants you to win and them to lose. Mm. They play their card the best they can.
Yeah.
And for us, you have to roll with the punches and take the avenues that are beneficial for your country, and slow down when it is the obstacle is too big and so on. But everyone does it his own way. I had my own way, and I survived with it.
There's a part in the book where you write about Justin Trudeau and you say that his team aspire to be reformists on a grand scale, but their lack of experience for succeeding in that goal is more and more apparent. You wrote that. I'm wondering what you're talking about there, what you think is maybe too big a promise.
But, you know, it is, for me, I had a different style in politics. And I was, you know, of course, I cannot pass what I would do today.
No.
I really
yes.
don't know. I'm not
yes.
there.
Yes.
But sometimes I thought that, you know, they would have been better served if they would have looked to have older, experienced people with them. I benefited from that.
Yes, yes.
We discussed that.
Yeah, yeah.
Mitchell Sharp was selected by Mike Pearson to train me.
Yeah.
And I think that it was rather not on, perhaps a success.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, so I believe in that
yeah.
because I'm the product of that.
Yes.
But others have a different style. And Justin, obviously, he does not think like me.
No.
Because he claimed that he's doing politics in a different way.
That's right.
But between you and I, politics is always politics. And you know, we cannot reinvent the wheels all the time.
Monsieur Chrétien, merci beaucoup.
Bienvenue, madame.